Kejar dia. Salah dari kais.
महाराष्ट्र शासनाचा शिक्षण आणि क्रीडा विभाग इस्रायलचा मुंबईतील वाणिज्य दूतावास आणि ऑब्झर्वर रिसर्च फाउंडेशन यांच्या संयुक्त विद्यमाने आयोजित केलेल्या दोन दिवसीय शिक्षक आणि शिक्षक प्रशिक्षकांच्या कार्यशाळेत आपलं मनापासून स्वागत. फ्रेंड्स, वी जस्ट हॅड लाइटिंग ऑफ लॅम्प्स विच इज अन इंडियन ट्रेडिशन. फॉलोड बाय दॅट देर वॉज अ वेलकम सॉन्ग बाय टीचर्स फ्रॉम व्हेरियस स्कूल्स इन महाराष्ट्र. That is to welcome our guests, our Israeli friends who might not understand the meaning. So it was that. मी आपल्या सगळ्यांचं स्वागत करतो. कार्यक्रमाची सुरुवात आपण आजचे जे प्रमुख पाहुणे आपल्याला लाभलेले आहेत त्यांच्या स्वागताने करणार आहोत. मी ऑब्झर्व रिसर्च फाउंडेशनच्या राधा विश्वनाथन यांना विनंती करतो की त्यांनी आज आपल्या ज्या कार्यक्रमाला जे प्रमुख पाहुणे लाभलेले आहेत, महाराष्ट्राचे शिक्षण मंत्री माननीय श्री राजेंद्र दर्डा साहेब, त्यांचं स्वागत करावं.
Shalom. For the sake of our colleagues from Israel, I will speak in English. आपल्याला भरपूर लोकांना इंग्रजी येत असेल, पण त्यांना मराठी येत नाही, म्हणून आपण इंग्रजीमध्ये बोलू. सो आय विल टेक ओनली टू मिनिट्स बिकॉज हॉनरेबल मिनिस्टर अँड सेक्रेटरी मॅडम, दे आर एक्सपेक्टेड टू डिलिव्हर देअर अड्रेस. आय विल मेन्शन ओनली टू थिंग्स. This is a country which produced Rabindranath Tagore, who dreamed for a country where the mind is without fear, where the head is held high, and where the world is not fragmented into narrow domestic walls. This was the country where he prayed to the God that let my country awake. This is a situation into which let my country awake. I think we are in the same direction. The world is becoming together, it's becoming small, interaction is more. As rightly pointed out by Mr. Miller, this is a new era of cooperation between these two countries. Let us take it forward like our country. As he mentioned, they also have diverse cultures. The only one difference is there, the mind-boggling numbers in this country. As he rightly pointed out, one district or two districts are equal to your country. So we are speaking in millions. But let me tell you the positive thing. There is one report which clearly says that by 2025, the only country in the world which can reap demographic dividend is India. China, because of the one child policy, they have reached their level. By 2025, that economy will also have less number of younger people. It is called graying of economy, graying of demographic status. So even China, which is a workshop of the world today, will become grayer. So the only country in the world, for whatever we thought that wrong reasons, that we are exploding in population, so we try to control. So after another 15 years, we are the only country which will have enough people to work in the workshop, to think and play a role in the laboratories also. But there is a big hitch. If we don't put intelligence into those minds, if we don't put knowledge into those minds, this entire demographic dividend may not become a dividend. It may become a loss. It may become a liability. So we are at a moment of time whether we are going to make this population a skilled, knowledgeable workforce, or are we going to create a population which is unemployable and becomes a liability. We really welcome the cooperation extended by Israel. Let us work together. And yesterday only your country's name was mentioned in one of the meetings in state level bankers committee informally. We were thinking about how to, Honorable Chief Minister in the meeting was speaking about drip irrigation. How to use modern methods of irrigation to reduce the water demand and improve productivity in agriculture. Someone was mentioning that Israel has the best possible way of using water to increase agriculture productivity. So there are many things to learn from Israel. As it is pointed out, it is a two-way communication. Let us start that. Only thing which our friends from Israel has to factor in is the language. So it will take some time to get into our type of language, or the communication will be a little difficult. So let us take that into consideration, so that maybe we have to go a little slow. Maybe we need a translator if necessary. That may be factored in. That is my only request. And I really thank the Israeli government, represented by Mr. Jonathan Miller and his all colleagues, for making this event happen, as well as ORF. Thanks to all of you.
धन्यवाद चोक्कनिंगम साहेब. आता मी विनंती करतो राज्याच्या शिक्षण आणि क्रीडा सचिव श्रीमती अश्विनी भिडे मॅडमना की त्यांनी येऊन आपल्याला मार्गदर्शन करावं.
ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर एज्युकेशन श्री राजेंद्र दर्डा सर, ऑनरेबल काउन्सिल जनरल ऑफ इस्रायल श्री जोनाथन मिलर, all his colleagues in the consulate, Aparna Shukumar from Observer Research Foundation, and all our colleagues in Observer Research Foundation, Chokalingam, our Commissioner Education, all my colleagues present here, and the very willing and excited participants of this training. I welcome all of you. We have been working on this training session for past 2-3 months, and I'm really happy that finally all these efforts have fructified and all of us are here to looking forward to a very exciting session of 2 days. All of us know that Israel is a very tiny country on the global map, but it stands tall in its achievements in various sectors. Traditionally, most of us know Israel's prowess in agriculture sector, and people keep on talking about it. But their achievements are not restricted only to agriculture. They have done wonders and made great achievements in the sector of information technology, research, and very high-tech industry. In fact, if I'm not wrong, Israel is known as the Silicon Valley of the Middle East today. How this tiny country with so many natural disadvantages, so much of resource crunch, how could they make it possible? I think the answer lies in their education system, very systematically adopted education system. Mr. Miller mentioned about the diversity in that country. People came from across the countries and basically they set up that nation. Of course, they had that fighting spirit, they had that national character. But in addition to that, what made that country or what has made that country is their education system. And that's why we have a lot to learn from them. Yes, the numbers are different. I mean, they are a country of 8 million. Our student strength is much more than the population of the entire country. Nevertheless, they have faced the same challenges. They have faced the same challenges of diversity, a bilingual kind of education system or culture. They have Hebrew as their local language, and plus they have to adopt English. We also face the same challenges, and that's why we have to learn a lot from them. Israel's education system, basically, that it has gone much beyond the rote system. They have moved outside the four walls of schools. What I could learn as the quick features of their system, I can just point out two or three of them. First and foremost is their basically insistence on innovation and creativity. I was really amazed to know their premise that creativity and entrepreneurial spirit can be cultivated. Generally, we feel that this is something which is original. This, you have to be born with these kinds of facets of our character. But no, this country has proved that if you can catch your children young, then you can definitely cultivate these qualities in them, and you can basically mold or shape the entire generation. And I think that is something which could be a great takeaway from this training session. And that's why their entire system has basically emphasized on igniting the impressionable minds, encouraging their creativity, and basically encouraging the entrepreneurial spirit right from the early childhood days. And they have institutionalized this. This is not happening as one or two experiments happening somewhere in the corner of the country. They have institutionalized this in a very, very systematic manner. And that's what we need to learn. In addition to that, they have a very wonderful program which the Council General has discussed with me when I joined and took over as secretary of this department. They have a program for the gifted children. They basically, while catching the children young, they identify the gifted children and they track them, they give them the kind of education which is appropriate for them. And this is how they basically build their generation. The third important feature of their education system is to encourage innovations in teachers. Teachers have been doing a lot of experiments, but how to encourage them? How to allow, basically encourage them to innovate more and then institutionalize it? Because what is innovation? Dr. Raghunath Mashalkar keeps on telling this in most of his lectures, that innovation is basically doing things differently. We need to do things differently. And while doing that, we have to basically pole vault and not leapfrog. So when you do it, you have to, again, if there are some scattered efforts of innovation, that won't make any difference on the entire system. There will not be any systemic changes. Of course, there will be tiny islands of excellence working at different locations. But if you have to change the system, then you have to institutionalize these innovations. And that's what Israeli system has done. And the last and the most important thing which I find interesting in their system is they have connected the schools to the communities around. Again, this education is not restricted in the four walls of a classroom. It is not just a dialogue between teacher and a student, or maybe a monologue at times, which happens in our case. The teachers speak and the students just listen. But in their country, what they have done, they have connected these schools to the communities. They have taken ample resources which are available in the local community, in the vicinity. They have taken advantage of that. They have basically connected their schools to their industry. And that is why when we were just discussing with all the experts here, and they told us, right from the school days, they start teaching children all the life skills, right from plumbing and carpentry to nanotechnology and to information technology. So they have understood the needs of the industry, needs of the entire country, what is their growth path ahead, and what kind of skill-based manpower we need, that they have identified. And while doing that, they have given emphasis that these children are basically, they become critical thinkers. because they want to create a country of entrepreneurs and not only job seekers. I think that is the most important thing for us. Chokalingam mentioned about the demographic dividend. Dr. Vijay Kelkar, who is a very, very famous economist, he has analyzed in a very nice way. If we don't utilize the potential which is there among our young population, we won't be able to reap the benefit of this demographic dividend. It could be converted into a big liability also. Unless we catch them young, unless we give them the necessary skills which are required for life, unless we basically train them in certain life skills and imbibe that kind of passion in a mission mode. And that is why I think the timing of this training or this workshop is very, very apt. We are on the crossroads. As education department also, under the able guidance of our minister, Shri Rajendra Darda, last 3-4 years, we have been trying to make so many structural changes. Yes, numbers is our challenge. How to reach out to almost 600,000 teachers and basically ask them to adopt new techniques of teaching, new pedagogy, new methodologies of teaching. That has been a big challenge for us. We have been doing it through cascading method of training. There have been a lot of transmission losses. Despite that, our system, our education system have achieved certain targets. Implementation of Right to Education Act has been quite impressive as far as our state is concerned. We have achieved the target of universalization of education, what we call. We have reached out to each and every child in that impressionable age. And that's why our enrollment has gone up substantially. Our dropout rate in the from primary to secondary schools, that has gone down substantially. But still a lot needs to be done, because we need to train our people in a very, very proper way. We have to make that learning more interesting, more useful for them. Because unless education is employable, unless it is skill-based, our children are going to find it useless. Because if they are not going to get jobs, if the education is not going to help them in improving their basically lifestyle, then they will develop a very negative attitude towards that. We have a major divide between our urban educational environment and rural environment. Urban system, apart from the schools, students have so many other resources from which they can learn. Parents are more aware. But in rural setup, students are completely dependent on teacher and the textbook. Nothing else is available from them to draw or learn the knowledge from. In such scenario, teachers have a major responsibility, a major role to play here. And the changes which we expect from teachers are attitudinal. The rest, everything you can learn, you can be trained, but the attitude has to be there. Attitude to learn new things, learn new methods. And those teachers who remain students throughout their career, they can be the best teachers, in my opinion. And that's why when we do various training programs, at times teachers complain that there is overtraining and this is too much of training. But you need it. Unless you interact with people, unless you meet people, you won't be able to improve yourself. And that is why such kind of training sessions are required. I'm very happy here that we have the entire training, all the sessions, if you see, they basically focus on innovations in methodologies, innovations in thinking, and how best you can utilize your limited resources in your classroom, and how best you can basically transmit whatever knowledge you have to your students. And we have Mr. Dr. Shafar Dov, Mr. Ojas, Hemant here, and I am sure that all of you are going to enjoy these sessions. My only request is, please make it an interactive session. Please do raise questions and do try to find those answers. Because once you start, that inquiry-based attitude has to be there first among the teachers, then only you will be able to imbibe it in your students. And in this group, sir, we have included some administrators also. Out of a group of 200 people, there are 50 educators, trainers and administrators, and about 150 teachers are here. So wherever we need some policy changes, where we need to make changes in our policy framework, keeping in line with whatever discussion happens here, we are even ready to make those changes. And an education department, we are open to these suggestions. In fact, we want to change the focus of the entire department. With permission from Mr. Miller, I'll just switch over to Marathi for one comment. Apla vibhaga shikshan, shaleya shikshan vibhaga hai. But sometimes mala asa vatte ki to shaleya shikshak vibhaga hai. Karan hota asa ki most of the times we keep on dealing with problems of teachers only, and most of our policies are basically they revolve around the problems of teachers. Fortunately, most of the teachers have their representation in a very substantial number in legislature. So we have just finished our assembly session, and our minister minister sir would also agree with me. We have 2 days of question hour days for education department, and out of 10 questions on priority, at least 6 are for education, and all of them are basically about teachers' welfare. So that is a very important factor, I fully aware, because we have a huge number, huge strength of teachers, that is more than 600,000. Naturally, there is a huge variety, there are going to be a lot of issues, and as department, we are committed to resolve those issues. But at the same time, we need to change the gear, we need to change the focus from teachers, from management, from the officers or of the education department to students, because they are the focal point of our system, and unless we change our attitude, we won't be able to achieve that. And I think we have been making various attempts in past 2-3 years to give a different kind of exposure to our teachers to help them in changing that attitude. Our English language teaching through British Council or the leadership program for our headmasters has been some steps in this direction taken by the department, and this is a step further, and this is not going to be a one-time exercise. I look forward to a prolonged collaboration with the government of Israel, since we have a lot to learn from them, we have a lot to share with them, and I think once we join hands, then we will definitely be able to make wonders and changes in our education system as well. I wish you all the best, and I thank Mr. Miller for extending this helping hand, and the entire team was so enthusiastic. The moment we thought of this idea, everybody started working. I must thank Observer Research Foundation, Mr. Sudhindra Kulkarni. He is not here today, but he may join tomorrow if I am not wrong. But Aparna and his entire team is here, and they have been very, very helpful. They are working as kind of a think tank for various sectors, and their inputs in education department are helping us a lot. I am thankful to my entire team, SCRT, because we suddenly imposed this program on them, but they immediately adopted it, and in fact they took the parentage and organized this program very nicely, taking advantage of me being the secretary sports. I directed my other wing to allow us to utilize this facility, which belongs to the sports department, and they were also happy to help us. So I'm really thankful to all the stakeholders who have made this program successful. Thank you.
धन्यवाद भिडे मैडम. आता मी आजच्या कार्यक्रमाचे प्रमुख पाहुणे आणि महाराष्ट्राचे शिक्षण मंत्री माननीय श्री राजेंद्र दरडा साहेब यांना विनंती करतो की त्यांनी आपल्याला मार्गदर्शन करावे.
Shalom. Shalom is near to salam. Honorable Consul General of Israel, Mr. Jonathan Miller, the representatives of Consulate of Israel in Mumbai, Aparna Shivkumar, other representatives of Observer Research Foundation, Ms. Ashwini Bhide, Secretary of School Education, Mr. Chokolingam, Commissioner of School Education, all the officers of the School Education Department, all the educators, participants of this training program, member of the press, friends. I am not going to make a very long speech, because the idea is communication has to be from both sides. So I am going to finish my speech in maximum 5 minutes. At the outset, I would like to say that this training program, in collaboration with the Consulate of Israel and ORF, is one more feather in the cap of School Education Department, Maharashtra. In the past 3 to 4 years, we have been making consistent efforts towards effective implementation of right to education and improvement in quality education. Apart from ensuring the policy framework, we have given emphasis on the comprehensive training to teachers on various facets. We have collaborated with the British Council for English Language and Leadership Training Program. We took assistance from Messrs. Accenture for Learning Outcome Training, and recently only we have entered into an MOU with the IIT Mumbai for Mathematics and Science Teachers Training through AVU technology. And as part of our quality enhancement initiative, we have also collaborated with the Consulate of Israel and ORF to organize this 2-day training program. And it gives me immense pleasure to be with you today and inaugurate the training program. As Honorable Council has rightly said, that there is a common thing between both countries, India and Israel, that we both have a unity in diversity. And we appreciate that. Friends, all of you are aware that Israel is a country small in size and have very limited natural resources. Yet the progress it has made in agriculture, research and high technology industry is absolutely mind-boggling. They have made it possible by making our education as a tool to transform the society. They have proved that we can cultivate creativity and entrepreneurship by way of an effective education system. And hence, it's very important for all of us to learn from them how to encourage innovative and out-of-box thinking in our children from the early age itself. When we say think outside the box, Marathit apan tyala manto chakorichya bahir jaun vichar kara. Out of box thinking is nothing but chakorichya bahir jaun vichar kara. Pan aplyala suruvati pasunach ayushya shikavlela ahe chakorit rahun jivan jagat ja. त्यामुळे आज अत्यंत वेगळ्या याच्यात आपण आज हे काम करायला आपण आजचं जे ट्रेनिंग आहे त्या दृष्टीने चालू होतोय. आय एम शुअर दिस 2-डे ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम विल ऑफर यू अ वंडरफुल ट्रेजर ऑफ न्यू लर्निंग्स. द एक्सपर्ट फ्रॉम इज्रायल आर हियर टू शेअर देअर एक्सपिरियन्सेस इन इनोव्हेटिव्ह एज्युकेशन. I had a chance to discuss with them before we came here. Friends, you are going to be the torchbearers of these new concepts, which can give you a new age in our education system. About 200 delegates, which include 150 teachers from higher secondary, secondary and upper primary sections are here. 50 of our officers or educators from BOs, EOs, DIET principals and SCRT officials are participating here. The focus will be more on innovations and vocalization, since education system in Israel is very good at that. experts will guide the participants on how to encourage creativity and entrepreneurship among the children from the early age. Actually, instead of when we were discussing, I was told that in Israel, instead of giving certificate, they are giving more thrust towards creativity and adaptability. And this is true in India. I had a chance to be a minister industry before I joined school education. At that time we used to talk that on one side we have unemployment. That is boys and girls who are educated, they are not getting the job. But on the other hand, as a minister industry, when I used to discuss matter with my friends from industry, they used to say that industry is not getting the skilled people. And hence, it's very important that when we are taking education, of course, we have to go through the books. But I'm sure you all educators, you will ask them, you will make them, make these children to ask why. And that's the most important. Apan Marathit bolto na, ke samudra madhe, jar tumhi 5 rupayacha nana jari panyat varun fekla, ta panyat jato, te khali budala jato. Pan 500 tanacha jahaj suddha samudrat budat nahi. You must encourage students to ask why. And once you start asking why, I'm sure. But I think they should start from today itself. I'm sure in this 2 days training, after the initial talk, you will always ask why it is said like this. Since my friends from Israel are here, it would not be out of place if I give a brief overview of the education scenario in Maharashtra itself. The span of education in the state is very vast. Nearly 21 million students are studying between class 1 to class 12 in 1,05,000 schools, and 7 lakh teachers are imparting education to them. Since we began implementing the RTE, right to education, in Maharashtra from 1st April 2010, we have basically concentrated on 3 parameters. We have made our syllabus equivalent to the national curriculum with an aim to impart quality education. We have realized that our teachers have to be outstanding if we want to mold good students. Hence, we have enhanced educational qualification of our teachers. We are using expert to train our teachers. As Madam, our school secretary, school education, has mentioned, that British Council has trained 60,000 primary teachers and 20,000 secondary teachers in English. We have also concentrated on improving infrastructure in our schools. We are also taking the help of the CSR activity in improving our infrastructure. Albert Einstein has said Education is not the learning of facts, but the training of the mind to think. And I'm sure after this 2 days training, our mind will start to think. Once you are good at it, tomorrow when you will be going to your classrooms, same thing you are going to put to the use with our students. Friends, I have brought with me the greetings of our Honorable Chief Minister, Mr. Prithviraj Chauhan. As you know, you had an opportunity to meet him. He is a man with a clear thinking. For everything he asked why. And that's why when he was a minister for science, he started Inspire Awards. Because in India, if you ask everybody, he will say, I want to be a doctor, I want to be a professor, I want to be a computer engineer. And very few, they want to go towards basic science. And to make basic science more popular, Honorable Chief Minister, as then Minister Science, he started Inspire Award. Friends, I'm greatly thankful to Mr. Miller, the Consul General of Israel, and also the Observer Research Foundation for organizing this wonderful program. The collaboration of ours will go a long way in ensuring the universalization of quality in education in our state. I wish you all the best for a successful training program. Thank you very much.
धन्यवाद श्री राजेंद्र दरडा साहेब. आपल्या विचारांनी आपल्या या कार्यशाळेला नक्कीच मोलाचं पाठबळ मिळालेलं आहे आणि पुढचे 2 दिवस अतिशय चांगल्या प्रकारचं शिक्षण प्रशिक्षणाचा कार्यक्रम आपल्या इथे होईल अशी मी अपेक्षा करतो. आपल्याला लवकरच प्रशिक्षणाच्या कार्यक्रमाला सुरुवात करायची आहे, पण त्याआधी एक पुस्तक प्रकाशन सोहळा आपल्याला करायचा आहे. ज्या प्रकारे गेल्या वर्षी अपर्णा शिवकुमार इस्रायलला गेल्या होत्या एका प्रशिक्षण कार्यक्रमासाठी, तसंच यावर्षीही एप्रिलमध्ये मुंबईच्या साठे महाविद्यालयाच्या प्राचार्य डॉक्टर कविता रेगे लोकसत्ताच्या करिअर अँड एज्युकेशन पुरवणीच्या संपादिका श्रीमती सुचिता देशपांडे आणि रुपारेल कॉलेजच्या प्राध्यापिका गायत्री गाडगीळ इस्रायलला जाऊन आल्या. तिथे जाऊन आल्यावर त्यांनी एक रिसर्च रिपोर्ट लिहिलेला आहे, त्याचं विमोचन आज आपण करणार आहोत. पण यानिमित्ताने मी आपल्याला सांगू शकतो की इस्रायलच्या परराष्ट्र मंत्रालयाद्वारे शिक्षण क्षेत्रात अनेक प्रशिक्षण कार्यक्रमांचं आयोजित करण्यात येतं आणि आपल्यापैकी ज्यांना इंटरेस्ट असेल या ह्याच्यात पार्टिसिपेट करायला आम्हाला नक्की कळवा, आम्हाला आनंद होईल. मी आता विनंती करतो डॉक्टर कविता रेगे आणि श्रीमती सुचिता देशपांडे यांना स्टेजवर यावं, आपल्याला त्यांच्या संशोधन अहवालाचं प्रकाशन करायचं आहे. या पुस्तकाबरोबरच इस्रायलमधील एकूणच शालेय आणि उच्च शिक्षण क्षेत्रात कोणत्या संधी आहेत, इस्रायलमधल्या विद्यापीठांबद्दल एक कॉन्सुलेट जनरल ऑफ इस्रायलने एका पुस्तकाचं हे तयार केलेलं आहे, तेही आम्ही आपल्याला या समय देऊ इच्छितो.
Thank you.